डॉक्टर के आनंद कुमार, एमडी इंडियन इम्यूनोलॉजिकल लिमिटेड. सो सर, प्लीज टेल अस व्हाट एग्जैक्टली यू आर प्लेइंग ए रोल इन वैक्सीन मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इन द कमिंग डेज.
ओके. करंटली आईएल इज वन ऑफ द लार्जेस्ट वैक्सीन मैन्युफैक्चरिंग कंपनीज इन द कंट्री. वी आर अ सब्सिडरी ऑफ द नेशनल डेयरी डेवलपमेंट बोर्ड. We make both human and animal vaccines. And today the country is going through a very bad time because of COVID-19. And it's been well proven that vaccination is one of the most cost-effective interventions to eradicate this disease. So currently, in order to increase the capacity for vaccine production in our country, Indian Immunologicals Limited, which is a subsidiary of the National Dairy Development Board, has come into a technical collaboration agreement with Bharat Biotech Limited, which is also based in Hyderabad. Indian Immunologicals Limited has several manufacturing plants, and what we are doing is one of the plants we are going to repurpose to make COVID-19 vaccine there. Already all the agreements with Bharat Biotech have been done. The technology transfer is in progress. We have already taken some trial batches at Indian Immunologicals Limited based on the technology provided by Bharat, and the outcome is very good. Whatever the yields and the process that Bharat follows has been replicated in Indian Immunologicals Limited in a very, very short period of time, because the country needs urgently several million doses of the vaccine. So it is IL's strength in vaccine manufacturing that enabled to get this technology and adapt it in IL at a very, very short period of time. So we are going to use one of the facilities located in Hyderabad, which earlier we were making rabies vaccine, and now we will use it for COVID-19 vaccine manufacture. Now, the way that we have done is that there won't be any shortage of rabies vaccine, because we have another plant where we have increased the capacity for rabies vaccine there, so that will meet all the requirements of the company now. Presently, we are planning to start manufacturing from the 15th of June, and the first batch we are expecting it to come probably end of July. And initially, the capacity will be 2 to 3 million doses per month. We are planning to do it in two phases. The first phase would be that we will repurpose an existing vaccine facility where we will get about 2 to 3 million doses a month. And we are also building another new viral antigen manufacturing facility, which will give an additional 5 to 6 million doses a month. So in all, we can say that about 8 to 10 million doses a month will be provided by IL. We are involved directly in the manufacture of antigen drug substance, and the drug substance will be provided back to Bharat, who will formulate it and make it into a final vaccine product.
So that means you will be producing drug substance,
yeah,
only?
Yes.
And you will be handing over to Bharat Biotech?
Yes.
Where that will be converted into
the
form
of final
vaccine,
yeah,
which we are using currently.
Correct, correct.
So could you please throw some light about the difference between drug substance and how it will be converted there?
So basically, the most difficult and the complex part in any vaccine manufacturing is the making of the drug substance. Today the country is facing shortage of vaccine. It's not because of the drug product, it's because of the drug substance. So our role is to make drug substance, which is a much more complex process, and that we'll provide to Bharat, which they will convert into a final formulation.
What kind of support you are going to get from the government of India?
So we have approached the Department of Biotechnology for this project, for both phase 1 and phase 2 of this project. We have been in principle they have agreed to give us 60 crore rupees as a grant for this purpose.
And how much time you may be taking it for rolling over the first batch of
like we are starting manufacturing from the 15th of June.
Mm.
And the first drug substance, we expect to have it by end of July.
Okay.
So from there on, it will be every month we'll get 2 to 3 million doses every month.
Okay. What is the primary things you will require for making these drug substances? Are there any need for imports of chemicals and other things?
Yes, yes. Like currently for a lot of vaccines that we make, some of the suppliers are monopoly suppliers.
Mm.
And there are like say filters which are used in manufacturing process, or certain media, or serum, or whatever the chemical that is used to inactivate virus. They're all very few companies that make these.
Mm.
So they have to be imported from, but since we, the process of making COVID-19 vaccine is similar to making rabies vaccine in the sense that the cells used to grow the virus are the same, which is vero cells for both rabies and for COVID-19 virus. So predominantly the manufacturing process is similar. So that's why it's been very easy and for IL to absorb this technology in quick speed.
Actually, as you are saying, the process is very much similar to the rabies vaccine manufacturing. But why IAL has been delayed in stepping into this vaccination program? Are there any reasons behind it?
No, I mean, see, each company has taken a different approach to bringing out a vaccine. So the approach that was taken by Bharat was the simple and quickest approach, where it's an inactivated vaccine where you have to isolate the virus and then manufacture it. But manufacturing using an inactivated virus requires BSL-3 facilities. And there are various other platforms to make vaccines. So each company has its own, based on past experience about, or the kind of facilities that we have, to go about which platform to select and use. So for example, AstraZeneca, they have adenovirus platform, Covaxin is an inactivated virus, the Pfizer has an mRNA based. So we went for making a live attenuated viral vaccine in collaboration with Griffith University.
Mm.
So making a live attenuated virus, that means it's replicating a virus, and it is a very, very technologically challenging thing. So that's why it's taken us some period of time to develop this vaccine, and currently animal studies are going on with our vaccine candidate.
Mm.
But in the interim, since the requirement of the country's need for vaccines are very high, we offered one of our facilities to make Covaxin in our facility.
So are there any collaboration with institutions like CCMB, because you are talking about inactivated virus, and they have some expertise in this, and from starting onwards, especially
yeah.
with COVID-19. So, any collaboration in exchanging expertise in this context?
So, we have started a dialogue with CCMB. I mean, I myself have visited CCMB, the director of CCMB and his team visited IL. So, we are planning to collaborate, especially in the areas of, you know, there are various variants
mm-hmm.
of this COVID-19 virus. So one of the most interesting aspects for us is to determine how our virus vaccine candidate, its ability to neutralize various variants from other, whether it's the from South African or the Brazilian variant. So those kind of studies, we will seek the help of CCMB to do that, because they have various virus strains from other countries.
Since you said dialogue is on, at what level the current situation is?
Yeah, like so now currently animal studies are going on
mm-hmm.
with our vaccine candidates.
Mm-hmm.
As soon as we at a certain time point, like probably in a couple of weeks time, we will be having the the serum ready, which we will give it to CCMB for them to evaluate.
Mm-hmm. For our basic understanding, can we think your process of vaccine as you said it's inactivated virus based? So is it entirely different from that of Bharat Biotech, or they have completely similarities?
Which
Bharat Biotech?
No, our vaccine candidate is a live attenuated virus.
Live.
Bharat is an inactivated.
Inactivated.
Yeah.
So you will be giving this drug substance based on live virus?
No, it will be based on the inactivated. We are just
inactivated
going to replicate
virus.
Bharat's process
okay.
in our plant.
Okay.
Yeah.
You are helping Bharat Biotech
exactly.
to speed up their vaccine.
Yeah. Increase their vaccine
increase
capabilities.
Increase their vaccination output.
Yeah. Output, yeah.
throw some light about your setup, sir, manufacturing setups.
Yeah,
and
like
what are the capabilities and what is your plan to scale these things up?
Okay. See, we have three manufacturing plants in India. We have two in Hyderabad and one plant in Ooty. The Ooty plant predominantly makes rabies vaccine. And the plant in Hyderabad, we have two plants. One plant which is located in Karakapatla village, and the other plant is located in Gachibowli. So we have these plants where we make all kinds of vaccines for different platforms. Like, we are only company in India which has platforms for all types of vaccines. And we make vaccines for cattle, sheep and goats, for pigs, for children, humans. And we also have unique vaccines where probably we are the first in the world where we have developed a vaccine even for tapeworm for use in pigs. So we have about 1600 employees across the company, and last year our turnover was about 910 crores. So we are one of the things is that we have a pan-India reach, and we also export to more than 40 countries. And thing is that we have both the desire to be commercially viable, in the sense make money, and also do a lot of social good. So we have engaged ourselves in various CSR activities where we have adopted government schools around our manufacturing sites, where we provide all facilities to that school other than the teacher's salary and the textbooks. Everything in those schools are taken care by us. We provide uniforms, we provide all kinds of facilities for the children. And also we provide them gift milk, in the sense that we provide 200 ml of flavored fortified milk to all the children. So nearly about 2,000 children benefit from our gift milk program. Mm-hmm.
Coming to back to this vaccination, you said one of your plants, which are which is in manufacturing of rabies vaccine, is being converted into for COVID vaccine. So what are your plans to cope up with the previous activity which the plant is doing?
Yeah, so what we have done, what we have done is we have two plants that we make rabies vaccine. The other plant, which is located in Ooty, where we have increased the capacity of output from that particular plant. And moreover, the demand for rabies vaccine also is a bit less now because of these lockdowns, the number of people in the streets, also the fact that the schools are closed and children are not. So the naturally, the demand for rabies vaccine has reduced. So that is helping us in allocating one facility purely for COVID-19 vaccine manufacturing.
What about the safety levels, sir, for manufacturing this COVID-19 substance?
So the safety levels required to manufacture COVID-19 is a BSL-3 facility. The rabies vaccine facility that we already have is a BSL-2 plus facility. So we are undertaking some modernization work to enable all the features of BSL-3 facility. BSL-3. Made in this particular facility.
And finally, you just now spoke about the CSR activities.
Yeah.
Are you taking up any COVID-related CSR activities?
Not COVID-related CSR activities, in the sense that we just now have signed an agreement where we are going to engage a company to help a hospital, TIMS, which is located near our Gachibowli manufacturing plant, where we are planning to give an oxygen generating facility for about 100 beds. So the expenditure will be about a crore of rupees, which now is in the process.
By when you are expecting this to be completed?
See, we now are just as I speak, the MOU is getting prepared. And the agency that is going to implement this said that it will take about 5 weeks.